in a weak acid, the equilibrium, and it really is an equilibrium, is to the left. Ka is going to be less than 1, which means that not many of these form. These are the ones that are on the right. We don't get much hydronium ion. Instead, the acid tends to stay in one piece. It doesn't dissociate very much. It will do a little. It breaks apart, but mostly it stays together. And so this stays as a reasonably sized number, and these are smaller numbers. So the smaller the Ka, the weaker the acid. It just isn't interested in coming apart and forming hydronium ions. It doesn't want to donate a proton. So here are some weak acids. And there's tons of weak acids. So this is just a sample. So here's the acetic acid. Like I said, this is like in your vinegar. And you see there is only one H in this that's going to come off. It's the one that's attached to the O. It's not the ones that are attached to the carbon. That is a very strong bond because C and H are very similar electronegativities. So this is very nearly a perfect covalent bond, and it's very strong and isn't going to fall apart. This bond, the difference in electronegativities between H and O is significant. It's more of an ionic bond. It does come apart once in a while. You will see that throughout here. Formic acid, same thing. It's not this H that comes off. It's the one that's attached to an oxygen. Here's hydrofluoric acid, the one in this list that isn't an H attached to an O. This is the one in that halogen column that didn't end up being a strong acid. It's a weak acid. Why is that? This fluorine, it's tiny. So this bond length is very short. It becomes difficult for things to get away when they're so tightly connected. The hypochlorous acid is another. And we had the perchloric acid. This is the complete other end of the spectrum where there's only one oxygen attached to the chlorine. There's 4 of them. You know, how many oxygens are attached to chlorine? So it ends up being a weak acid. And nitrous acid, as opposed to nitric acid. Nitric acid had 3 oxygens. Nitrous has only 2 oxygens. And it turns out that it is a weak acid. And the weak acids have low numbers for their pKa's. Look at them. They all have these 10 to the minus something, right? And their pKa's tend to be a middling size. Now they want us to rank acids, and we want to do them in decreasing acid strength. So I want the strongest first and the weakest last. Oh, they've given me the Ka. I know the strongest is going to have the largest Ka, and the weakest then would have the smallest Ka. So now I can just go look at them in terms of their Ka. That one is way different than all the others. 10 to the minus 10. That's really, really, really tiny. That is the smallest one here. So that one's the weakest. Now, what's the strongest? This one, 10 to the minus 2. That's going to be the strongest one. Okay, the 3, pretty big, but it's not as big as that one. It's definitely the second strongest. Now, I have 2 others that I have to look at because they both have 10 to the minus 5. So I have to look at this part. 6.5 is bigger than
1.9.
So 6.5 is going to be stronger than that one. So the 6.5 and then this one. All I needed to know was the Ka, and I could rank them in terms of how strong they are. And they wanted decreasing, so I started with the strongest, which was going to be the one that dissociated the most, which had the largest Ka.